A small claims court.
You may be seated. Next case, Gladys Higgins versus Bernice Farnwell.
That's me.
And which are you, Farnwell or Higgins?
Farnwell, Bernice Farnwell.
And I'm Gladys Higgins. It's Mrs. Higgins, Your Honor. I have been happily married for 10 years.
Oh, Judge, they haven't been all that happy.
Ladies, may I remind you, this is a court of law, right? It may be a small claims court, but we still have our rules of decorum here. You're not to speak to each other, you're only to speak to me. Each of you will have ample opportunity to be heard.
Oh, and I have been happily married for 7 years.
Very well. Let's proceed. All right, who's the plaintiff here? It must be you, Mrs.?
Yes. You may call me Bernice, just everyone calls me Bernice.
Usually I address litigants by their last name.
Then to be fair, I should be called Gladys.
Yes, to be fair. Ladies, it's not that important what I call you. Can we get on with this? Okay, I see here that Bernice, that you're suing Gladys, $500 in payment for a dead parakeet. Let me first ask you, Bernice, up to this point, have you tried to get any compensation from Gladys?
Oh, I have, Your Honor, and she has refused. She even refuses to discuss it. That's what this has come to.
It was purely an accident, Your Honor.
I assume you're saying that something happened to this animal, this parakeet?
Her cat ate my bird.
He did not eat your bird. He just killed your bird.
It's the same thing. Why do you think a cat kills a bird? For sport? It kills to eat. That's what cats do.
Bernice! My cat did not eat your stupid bird. My cat does not have, is well taken care of. She doesn't have to kill her. She is very well fed. I need her.
Ladies, must I tell you again? You're going to talk to me, not to each other.
She has a very nasty habit of twisting the facts.
All right, Bernice, please, start from the beginning. Describe what happened.
Your Honor, I brought my bird to her house to be taken care of, since myself and Mr. Farnwell were to be gone a few days. As usual, Gladys was careless and left the birdcage door open. Evidently, my bird flew out of the cage and was subsequently killed by this savage cat of hers.
My cat is not savage.
The cat attacked Tutu and left her for dead.
The bird's name is Tutu.
Was. The thing is dead. Yes, Your Honor. With its feathers spread out, it looked like a tiny ballet dancer.
Ballet dancer? Give me a break. It's just a bird.
So Tiny Tutu was there on the floor, helplessly flapping around.
Now, Bernice, you were not actually there, so I can safely assume that you did not actually see Tutu flopping around on the floor.
Well, no. I was in Las Vegas.
Yeah, playing the slots while I was left with the bird.
But I can imagine her helplessly flapping with broken wings while that feline is ready to pounce again.
Oh, wait. Here come the fireworks, just like when we were kids. She was waterworks, she knew just how to get sympathy. She could
Gladys,
turn on tears like a faucet. I mean, I'm
Gladys,
telling you, Judge.
Must I warn you again? Please. Wait. Did you say, just like when we were kids? You two have known each other since childhood?
Yes, she was my younger sister.
I am your younger sister, Gladys.
So here I I am presented with the sorry spectacle of two sisters, one suing the other? You're telling me there's no other way for this to be solved?
You must hear the whole story, Your Honor.
Bernice, if you knew your sister had a cat, and this cat could present a clear and present danger to Tutu, why on earth would you bring your parakeet over to her house? For example, why didn't you just have Gladys go to your home and feed the bird there?
I had no choice. Gladys doesn't drive.
And there was no one else around you could ask?
No, I just moved into a new neighborhood. I don't know anyone there.
Let me ask Gladys some things now. Gladys, what were the circumstances that led up to the early demise of Tutu?
Well, thank you, Your Honor, for finally hearing my side of it.
Let me just say that I've never liked birds. I'm always afraid they're going to fly in my face. In fact, I'm afraid to even be around birds.
Then why did you agree to take care of the parakeet?
Well, she showed up at my doorstep with the birdcage in hand. What could I say?
Just showed up?
Yes.
Now, Bernice, were you aware of Gladys's strong dislike of birds? I mean, you knew she did not like birds, yet you brought the bird over and the cage to her home?
Judge, like I said, I had no choice. Oh, I could have left her there and let Tutu starve, if you call that a choice.
Or you could have chosen not to go to Las Vegas.
Ha! Score one for the judge!
All right, now let's skip ahead. Gladys, given that you tacitly accepted possession of
tacitly?
The bird, well, that is to say you didn't say no. By your silence, you accepted custody of the bird. Did you then take proper care to see that the bird was not to be harmed?
Well, I put the cage on the table, and then I put a cover over the cage.
You did what?
I put a cover over the cage.
May I speak, Your Honor? A cover over the cage makes Tutu think that it's nighttime. She would be completely disoriented and confused.
Oh, disoriented and confused. You always love to exaggerate. It's a bird. I wanted to keep it quiet. That constant chirping was driving me crazy.
Tutu doesn't chirp. She sings. Parakeets sing.
And then what happened, Gladys?
I went over to put some food into the cage, some bird seed, something to quiet it down. I opened the gate to the cage, and I put my finger in with the little cup thing, and the bird pecked me.
Tutu doesn't peck.
And what do you think this is? This is a peck. She pecked me, and I ran away from the cage, terrified and bleeding.
A tiny peck would not cause bleeding. Any bruise or tiny cut was always a major emergency.
All right, please, lady, we're getting off the track here. Peck or no peck, we've established then that the bird did in fact leave the cage.
Yeah, I screamed. I thought it was going to fly in my face.
Tutu does not fly in faces.
All right, and at what point did this cat enter this pretty picture?
The bird flew around the room a few places, onto the end table, then onto a sofa, and then Merlot spotted it and pounced. Oh, Merlot is my cat's name. We name all of our animals after wines. It's my husband's idea.
You heard her say it, Your Honor. The cat pounced. Pounced and tried to eat Tutu.
What? She did not eat your bird. She simply, she held it in her mouth.
Can you imagine the fear in that poor bird finding itself in the jowls of that feline beast?
The cat held the bird in its mouth? Then what happened?
I shouted at Merlot to let the bird go. She let go for a moment. Then the bird got away, and Merlot pounced again. This time, she pounced even harder.
You mean the bird was now
dead? She moved her wings for a moment, then nothing.
Oh my God. I can only hope that Tutu's last moments were free of pain.
It was over very fast. I'm sure that there was no psychological drama.
All right, now, ladies, granted, that Tutu is no longer with us and that a cat and a bird are a deadly combination, I don't see the basis for the amount of compensation you're asking for, Bernice.
Pain and suffering. You have no idea what I've been through. What
Tutu went through. Well, spare me the hysterics. It was a bird. Do you think it had a charmed life, trapped in the cage day after day, eating pitiful seed?
Tutu was my baby.
Oh, you see, Your Honor, what happens to a childless couple? They become obsessive about a Tweety bird. If you ask me, it's not healthy.
Now, Bernice, granted that you've lost a pet, to which you've become attached, can't you buy another parakeet? What do they cost? $50?
Oh, all of them get cheaper than that. And she can have the damn bird cage back.
The court does not award pain and suffering compensation in small claims. The most I can consider is the cost of replacing the bird.
No bird can replace you two.
Oh, get over it, Bernice. Get another one the same color. You won't even know the difference.
Your sister's right, Bernice. I'm sure you can develop an affection for another bird.
Yeah, look at my point of view in this. I had this bird and bird cage foisted upon me on my doorstep, not even a phone call saying that she was coming.
I tried to phone. Her line was busy for 2 hours, probably ordering things from the home shopping network.
Well, why shouldn't I have nice things? You always had nice things. Mother always favored you.
Ladies.
You're the one that got the pretty bow. You're the one that got to wear her jewelry.
Ladies.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. No. You are the pretty one.
Can I ask each of you a question? What is your sister worth to you?
You mean dollars and cents?
Pesos, pounds, euros, I don't care. Her value, any way you want to express it. Maybe something non-monetary would be more appropriate.
Well, we did have some good times together. We had some fights, but mostly they were good times.
Well, she used to look after me. After all, she is my older sister.
And I assume neither of you would want to break up this relationship, especially over a pet.
Well, she still has her cat. My tutu is gone forever. But I suppose a sister is worth more than a pet.
No, I guess a bird is a bird, and a cat is just a cat. They're replaceable.
And I think we all realize that. Please. In fact, I have a solution. Turns out I have a bird, which I frankly don't like very much. Sorry, Bernice. My sister thought I needed company. I don't need company. After a day in this madhouse, I need peace and quiet in large quantities. This parakeet never shuts up. Many times I've thought of, shall we say, setting it free.
Oh, parakeets make wonderful companions, Judge.
I suppose. But I'd dearly love to get rid of this bird. Bernice, let my clerk know how to contact you. I'll see you get possession of this lovely bird. And I'll even throw in 5 pounds of bird seed.
Well, there you are, Bernice. You won't know the difference from Tutu. Just imagine that Tutu has gone to a better place.
All right, needless to say, Bernice, you'll sign the paperwork and end this claim. All right, now go see my clerk.
Well, Judge, I think I can.
I think you can. My job is to solve disputes. You get a new bird, Gladys gets her sister back, I get peace and quiet. It's a win-win. Win. McNabb versus McNabb. What's this? Two brothers suing each other over Lakers tickets? I went to law school for this?